call the word of God,
ma così non c'è mai niente da
fare. The more our hearts,
dirò,
the more our spirits,
dirò,
are conditioned to think like God.
Inaweza kufikiria kama Mungu.
Are conditioned to react the way God reacts.
Inaweza kufikiria vile Mungu anavyofikiria.
Because it is the word of God.
Kwa maana ni neno la Mungu.
That attracts the spirit of God.
Ambayo inaleta roho.
It is the word of God in your hearts.
Ni neno la Mungu katika
roho. That attracts the spirit of God in your life.
Ambayo huvutia roho ya Bwana katika
moyo. It is the word of God in your heart.
Ni neno la Bwana ndani ya moyo.
That attracts the spirit of God in your life.
Ambayo huvutia nafsi ya Bwana
katika moyo. It is the word of God in your heart.
Ni neno la Bwana ndani ya roho.
That attracts the spirit of God in your life.
Ambayo huvutia roho ya Bwana katika
moyo. The word in your heart.
Neno ambalo liko ndani ya moyo wako.
The life that you live in the outside. So it is the word of God in your heart. That determines the life that you live. So the more we meditate on the word, the more our hearts are conditioned to attract the things of God, to attract the spirit of God. And if we do it for a long time, and we do it consistently, it reaches a certain point that even if you are on the road and someone calls you to pray for them and you declare a word, it happens immediately. You don't have to tell them that I will go and pray for you when I reach home. When you condition your spirit to attract the Holy Spirit, anywhere you are, in any place you go, anytime you declare, something always takes place. Because the Holy Spirit does not live in a certain place. He lives in you. He lives in your body. The Bible says that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. When you are in the market, your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. When you are in your house, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. When you are in church, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. When you are driving, when you are flying, your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. So wherever you find yourself, your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And when you understand this, you can never say, I'm not ready to pray now. I cannot pray for you in this place. I will pray for you only when I get into church. The Holy Spirit does not only live in church. The physical church. The Holy Spirit lives in the church. And that church, it is your heart. Your heart is the embassy of God. It is the house of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Ghost lives in that house. Lives in that church. And that church, it is your body. That's what the Bible says. That your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. In other words, your body is the church of the Holy Ghost. So where does the Holy Ghost live? He lives in you. In the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit used to live in a certain place. People had to go to a certain place in order to access God. They had to go to the temple. And there is a certain place used to call the innermost place. And not everyone could access that place. The Holy of Holies. Only the priest could enter the Holy of Holies. And he would pray for the other people there. And for people to receive, they had to go to the temple to pray. But in the time we are living in, there's no And he has said,
akasema,
you and me,
wewe na mimi,
we are the temples of the Holy Ghost.
Sisi ndio kanisa la Roho Mtakatifu.
We are the mobile church of Jesus
Christ.
We are not a static church that stands in one place. We are a mobile church. We are a moving church. When we go in the village, we are still the temple of the Holy Ghost. And God moves in the village.